students, and welcome to another Puuwks lesson. Today we will be talking about how to create an apology video. Now obviously I don't need these glasses, and I look like a neek with them on, so I'm gonna take them off for the rest of the video. But I am still your teacher, and you must address me as Mr. Pewterschmidt. So let me give you a little hypothetical, class. Let's say you are a YouTuber, and you just got into some recent drama. It could be you faked a video, said something bad on stream, said something bad on Twitter, it could be anything. Even pedophilia, which seems to be the main contributor to most people's downfall. Like, seriously guys, it's not that hard to just not like kids. Like, come on. But if you are a YouTuber that just got into some drama, like, let's say Pokimane, or that woman with the ukulele, or Sniper Wolf, then this video is for you. So, sit back, get your notepad out, and enjoy. Lesson 1 is very, very crucial to how your apology video will come out. You need to get the performance correct. You need to act the perfect way for an apology video. I mean, we all know the Logan Paul video where he goes, "I made severe and continuous lapse in my judgment." So you probably want to mention that. Kind of like Sniper Wolf, where she ended off her paragraph, that was definitely written by ChatGPT, with, "I made a severe and continuous lapse in my judgment." However, there are also some other key points that you need to keep throughout the video. For example, starting off the video, you have to give a deep sigh, like this. Guys, I really didn't want to have to make this video. See, just start it off like that. That is the perfect way to engage your audience and just get them knowing that you are sad. Obviously, you don't have to mean it. None of the YouTubers do. But the most important thing is looking like you care. Also, a little bonus tip. If you have a dog, then that definitely helps. Just bring it in frame and preferably say to the dog, "I don't know how we're going to do this video." And if you're a rich YouTuber doing this, a very popular YouTuber, preferably film it in your mansion and just have a Land Rover in the background to flex on all your audience. Also, for ending off your video, instead of just cutting away and just fading to black, you have to include the part where you turn off the camera, like this. So I hope you guys can forgive what I did. I'm very sorry, and I'll see you all next video. Just like that. It makes people think that you are, you know, more human than you are. Because obviously you're a YouTuber, you're a slimy little scumbag. You don't care. You don't care about what you did. None of the YouTubers do. But you have to act like you do. That's very important. Lesson 2 is a classic. All the big YouTubers do it. When you see a YouTuber apology, either on Twitter or on YouTube, a main trend is that they don't really address the issue. For example, James Charles, when he had all that drama, saying, you know, that he talked to some minors, which again, guys, it's not that hard, just don't talk to kids. He made an apology video. He actually made a few, but he didn't really, he danced around the problem. He didn't really address the main thing. He didn't say, I think he did say sorry, but like, it wasn't like a main sorry. But also with like, Sniper Wolf, she didn't actually say sorry. She just typed in, "Write me an apology video" to ChatGPT, and that's what she got. Also, a reason that YouTubers don't, you know, actually say sorry in their videos is because it leaves it open to, you know, to make more apology videos. If you don't actually say sorry, you can then milk the drama for like 5 videos and make bank off of just one little issue. So moral of lesson 2, just dance around the problem, don't actually say sorry. Sorry is one of the worst things you can say in an apology video. A better thing would be saying, "I'm sorry you felt that way," or "it wasn't my intention to make people feel this way." That way you don't actually get any, you don't put any like responsibility on yourself. You just say that it's the viewer's fault and that they should be, you know, different, they should feel differently, not that you should be sorry. It's very, very good manipulating and a very good tactic. But now on to the last lesson. The last lesson is for advanced students only. So if you follow the last 2 lessons very closely, then you can do this one. Once you've made your apology video and your first apology video and you don't actually say sorry, you then have to wait a few days, months, years even, and then do it again. If it's something as bad as like pedophilia or like an actual crime, then don't, obviously. But if it's something just minor, like you faked a video or whatever, keep doing it. You'll get more views, and everyone knows apology videos get a bajillion views when YouTubers upload them. Because everyone wants to, you know, listen to what they have to say. Usually, drama is the only thing that keeps a dead YouTuber afloat. For example, you had that lady who made, like, cooking videos that, like, tried to bring out Mr. Beast as this guy who fakes videos. Which, come on, guys, he probably does script them. Like, you don't make videos that big without scripting them. Like, come on. But her channel was dead in the water. You know, she got barely any views. But once she did this, you know, drama against Mr. Beast, she was relevant for a few days. And that's all a dead YouTuber can ask for. Relevance for a few days, maybe even months. But if you want to be featured on Moist Critical a few times, say sorry and then do it again. To just keep milking that sorry train. So that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching. And I would love to see your apology videos. Your homework today is to go out and commit criminal acts on YouTube. Not pedophilia. Okay, not that much. I don't want to be responsible for that. So thank you very much for watching. There will be videos hope you enjoy.
Peter, what are you doing?
Crack.
What the fuck?
Hey, at least I'm not drinking, Brian.